old as most of you are right now. From an early age, though, I knew I was destined for greatness, destined to do something beyond this world. You see, God blessed me with such beauty, which led to many men becoming infatuated with me and offering gifts of marriage. However, I knew I had but one spouse, Jesus Christ, my Lord and my God. From there, I knew I was called to live a life of heroic virtue. I lived many years ago in a time where people were persecuted for their faith. We were forced to worship false gods, but I knew I could not do this. One day, the governor's son took me to a temple to worship these gods. These gods had no power to save me, had no power to conquer sin and death. They did not come to this earth in human form and die in my place. Why did I have to worship to them? I was to love God with all my heart, mind, soul, and strength. So I offered the simplest prayer I knew, one of the most powerful prayers we have to this day. I made the sign of the cross, the sign we are sealed with at baptism and blessed with our whole lives. Many years later, a great saint will come to say that the sign of the cross makes all of hell tremble. For me, it filled me with the courage and conviction and strength. The governor's son immediately accused me of being a Christian, an offense punishable by death. I was brought before the governor, who offered me many chances to deny my faith, to deny my Lord. But why would I do that? He offered me many gifts, but I was not going to take those material things in a new form of God. They could not kill a virgin, so they planned on having my precious gift taken from me. They stripped me of my clothing, put me in chains, and dragged me through the streets to a brothel. An angel of the Lord came down and protected me from their snares of lust and impurities. All they had to do now was take me back to the place where I was to be killed. Even pagans, unbelievers, cried out for me to be saved. I was so young and shone with radiant joy. How could they kill someone so innocent? But they did what they had to do. They offered me one last chance to deny my faith. But all I could say was, it would offend my spouse if I was to please you. He chose me first, and he shall have me. And with that, I bowed my head and waited for the sword to fall. And now I pray to God that he grants you the courage to live a life full of chastity and purity, with honor and integrity, just as he did for me. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.